Howdy folks, Kel here. Well, I have a kind of a watch review here and some other things here. It is a military watch company watch. I just received this here the other day. And I was very much looking forward. Now some of you guys are going, Kel, what the hell are you buying a military watch company for, you moron? Don't you know I'm old or junk? What's wrong with you, you moron? Well, I don't know. That's a good question. Here's what it comes with, a little guarantee thing there, a little plastic package thing there, and there's the watch box, military watch company. I've been looking at these for a while, and I'm not going to go into why I bought this watch. In fact, I bought this watch instead of a Steinhardt, and that'll really freak you guys out. I'm not going to even go into why right now. I will make a video why I ordered this instead of a Steinhardt. I have my reasons. I know it sounds completely insane, and maybe I am completely nuts, and probably was. But anyway, here's the watch. Put this aside. Take a look at it. It's got the little plastic protector on it, which I'm going to leave on for the time being for various reasons. But that's the watch right there. It comes on a little tan. Also comes with a little black. They come with a black strap as well. Now this is the automatic. This is the automatic with what I think is a Miyota. Japanese automatic movement, which I understand is not a bad movement actually. There's a close-up. Maybe we'll do close-up. Well, it's ticking now. It had stopped. It's ticking probably because I'm moving it around. That's okay. Well, I initially got it, I wound it up, and I set the time and everything, but now it's just... But you can see the three pan there. That might give you... Might be something you want to look at. A little sweet pan deal. Now, this has mineral glass, which I prefer sapphire, of course, but again... Now, I paid $205 for this watch. I didn't pay the retail by any means whatsoever. I bought this from a guy on eBay who sells these. He's a dealer in these. But it's not the military watch company eBay website, just to let you know. So I got a really good deal. And I'll explain why I bought it. Well, I'll tell you why right here. I bought it because I wanted kind of an everyday automatic and just to kind of dip my toe into the automatic watch market. That's why. I could have, see if my camera will focus close in. I could have bought, you know, a Steinhardt, could have afforded to, and I was going to. I just didn't feel like spending the almost $500 for a Steinhardt right now. And actually, you know, it's a pretty good looking watch. If you look at it, it's a pretty good looking watch actually. You know, the back's got stuff on, doesn't matter. But it's a pretty good looking watch overall. I'll tell you something I do like about this watch. It has a little sweeping here with little points on the end right there. Which is, you know, it's a Rolex Submariner watch, obviously. I'm not trying to fool anybody, and then I've got a Rolex by any means, and this wouldn't do that. But I like this shape very much, which Steinhardt doesn't have, and I wish they did. I love the shape of the back, of the sides. Once again, Steinhardt, and it's really quite a nice-looking watch, actually. It's got a nice polish to it. It's a satin-finished kind of polish. It's very nice-looking that way. You know, the face is black. It's got the nice little, you know, Mercedes-Benz hands. You know, it's got a really nice-looking crown here, which is a screw-in crown, by the way. So, actually, it's not a bad watch. And I'm going to put it on my wrist real quick here, if I can do that. With the camera here in front of me. I'll just do it off-camera here, and I'll bring it back. Sorry about that, but it takes a minute or two here to get this kind of thing going. So, I'm going to put it on my wrist and show you what it looks like for wrist presence. Hell, I'll tell you why I bought this watch. Because this watch here has spoiled me. This is my favorite watch. It's a Seiko chronograph, and it's my favorite watch. And it's got about a 42 millimeter bezel, a little bit over maybe, and it's got a big wrist nice wrist presence because it's got a whatever. Anyway, it's got a nice wrist presence. I like it, and I've kind of gotten spoiled. And I was going to get a Steinhardt, but I thought, well, Steinhardt's like a 42, which is similar to that. But kind of was thinking I wanted a bigger watch, right? I'll just show you this while I'm talking about this stuff. And I'm thinking I kind of wanted a bigger watch, right? And I don't want something too big. I'm not into the big watch craze at all. Not into that at all whatsoever. But I just thought that a little bigger watch might be kind of a nice thing. You know, because some watches look too small on the wrist. I've got a bunch of watches, and some I'm like, they just feel too small now for me. I don't want a 46 or a 50 or anything like that, any of these crazy sizes, but I want something a little bigger. And this watch here is advertised to have a 43 millimeter case, and the case is measured by the case itself, not the bezel. That would mean the bezel itself would be about 44, which would be nice. You know, this bezel here is about 42, like I say, a little over 42. I've got watches that are just under 42, and they just are too small for me, in my opinion. Those watches are going to probably be going bye-bye. So I got this watch, and I actually like it. I think it looks good on my wrist pretty much. I've got about a 7.5-inch wrist, which is pretty large. Never have had a NATO strap before. That's kind of cool. I'm not big on it, but it's all right. I was going to put a Clockwork Synergy strap on this watch, which I don't have one here right now. I'm sorry about that, but and all that stuff. Anyway, but on the second day of having this watch, I look it on my wrist and something struck me funny about it. It struck me odd. I didn't know what it was. And I'll take it off here. Something struck me odd, and it kind of bothered me. I couldn't tell. It was vibrating on the edge of my subconscious. I could not figure out what was odd about it. You know, something was just not quite satisfying. I couldn't figure out what that was. Until I brought out my handy-dandy caliper. And I measured the bezel. The bezel should be, again, you know, if it's 43 case watts, the bezel goes over the case, as you can see. So the bezel should be 44, maybe. So I measured the bezel. I'll measure right here for you guys. I don't know if you can see that or not. But the bezel isn't even 42. It's actually smaller than this watch. It's actually smaller. That's kind of insane. How can that be? How can a 43 millimeter case watch have a bezel which is smaller than 42? That's like a magic trick of some kind. So I measured the back of the watch. Now this is the edge of the watch here, and this is the other edge. Just see where that crown is? I think I'm being generous enough to say you can measure from the bottom of that crown to the top, to where the crown starts, right there, see what I'm measuring? To the other side of the watch, and come up with what? It's barely 40. Now this watch is supposed to be 52 millimeter lug-to-lug width. Lug-to-lug width is right here. It's supposed to be 52 millimeters. Can you see what that is? Lug-to-lug, it's 48 3/4, something like that. This watch is not the proper size. This is not the specs that it says it is on the auction, as a matter of fact. Also, this watch is supposed to be 15 millimeters thick, and I don't really like watches that are that thick that much, but just for, you know, argument's sake. But it really is about 13 millimeters thick. You can see there. This watch is not the right size. And I looked at the website for MWC Watches, a military watch company, and it's not like they make a ladies version or something like that, you know. It would be smaller. You know, all their watches that are Submariner automatics, as far as I can tell, maybe I missed something, it could be, all their watches are, you know, these sizes. They're 15 millimeter thick. They're lug to lug is supposed to be 52. And again, lug to lug makes a difference with me, because the lug size really kind of decides the watch presence on the wrist. It's about 48.5. This watch here is a little over 50, if you can see that. And it makes a difference on the wrist. It really makes a difference in wrist presence. But anyway, this watch is not the right size. And I nicely wrote the dealer and said, hey, I said, you know, I'm mismeasuring this. And guess what? It doesn't seem to be the right size. And this has got the plastic covering on here, which I'll leave on. I took it off, but I'm going to send it back here to him. And he was surprised. He asked me to send photos. Now, the glass is about 30. It's supposed to be 31. So even the glass is a little bit, you know, the crystal is even a little smaller than it really says in the specs. It's a good-looking watch. And honestly, I would have kept it if it had been the right size. I would have kept it and wore it every day and played with it and had fun with it, you know. And you know, would not have cared too much about what happened to it. You know, I don't beat my watches at all. Like, here's a watch I've had for, you know, for probably 10 years or more. And you can see there's never a scratch on that crystal. That's Hardlex Seiko crystal. There's never a scratch on that, you know. So that just shows you how well I take care of my watches. I don't beat them around. I've trained myself not to bang my watches on doorways. When I first had a good watch, I did bang the hell out of them. could say the same thing if it's one of my girlfriends, but that would be crude. Anyway, so I'm sending it back. And he has agreed to refund and also to refund my shipping back to him. I don't know what's going on here. I'm not going to tell you this guy's name. He's a dealer in these watches on YouTube. He's a licensed dealer from a military watch company, supposedly. It's not the actual company website on YouTube. It's not their thing. But I don't know if, and I don't think, it could be a counterfeit. I mean, there are counterfeit military watch company watches around. I don't think this is one. If it's a counterfeit, it's a damn nice one. It would work just as well as the regular one, as long as there's that good movement inside, the good Japanese movement. The point is, I think military watch company has changed the size of their watches and haven't bothered telling anybody. This poor guy, you know, here's the odd thing. The size including the crown, you may be wondering about that, if I can get it here. The size including the crown is, well, I'll do it from the back because, well, I guess I can do it from the front. I don't know. The size including the crown is about 45 and a half. It's supposed to be 46. But then if you add the bezel, I suppose, you could say, you know, that it's basically 46. Now, that's a weird thing. That size is correct. So I don't know what's going on here. You know, I don't know what's going on. I mean, even if you said, well, Kelly, you're supposed to measure the watch case this way, which you're not, you know, it still wouldn't make any sense, you know. I mean, and also the length of the, you know, the lugs doesn't make any sense. Mostly 52, instead it's 58 and a half or whatever. So it's going back. I'm not going to give you the guys. I don't think he was caught unawares. He was shocked. He said he was surprised. He had me send the photos, and I did. I think he was kind of surprised. I don't know what's going on here, you know. I'm almost tempted to order one from Military Watch Company, but I've decided to do instead. I'm going to just buy a Seinhardt. Don't really want to spend the money. Didn't want to spend the money, but I've been really a big fan of their watches for a long time, and I know everybody else is. So I'm just going to buy a Seinhardt and be done with it is what I'm going to do. It's a good-looking watch. It's much better looking than the picture show it to be. You know, it's nice and nicely polished. You know, it's a satin finish, but it's a nicely satin finish polish on there. You know, it's got a really nice looking little crown. I mean, you know, the bezel's nice. Now the bezel, it has a pretty nice little click to it, which is I kind of like. Whether you hear that or not, it does move a bit back. So you got to kind of move it and then move it back one to get it where you want it to stay. You know, if you want to have it on the top, like I do and most of you fanatics do, you've got to kind of move it and then back, click and back, click and back. But it does stop. It's unidirectional. You know, it's a nice looking watch, and it would be fine with me. I wouldn't mind spending $200 on this watch, a nice automatic Japanese movement, you know. But it's not the right size. This should be bigger than this watch. You know, this should have a 40, you know, 3.5 or 44 millimeter bezel, you know. And it should have a bigger wrist presence of, you know, 52. So I'm just saying that. Here's the really weird thing. I have watched videos on YouTube of this watch, and I know. And those videos had, the watch seemed pretty gigantic. There's like two videos on with it where a guy takes it for the cell phone. And he has one, you know, and he shows the watches, you know. And those are pretty gigantic looking watches to me. His watch is pretty gigantic looking. I mean, even if he has small wrists, it's a pretty damn good sized watch. This isn't. It's like a girl's version or something, a woman's version of the watch. It's very strange. So it's going back. Hopefully he will refund and want money. I mean, it is guaranteed by eBay, so if he doesn't want to, eBay will refund my money. So, it's just very strange. I just thought I'd show it to you. I guess I'd say, you know, if you order one of these watches off eBay or off Military Watch Company, I suggest you talk to them very carefully and ask them to actually measure the watches now, because if this is not a counterfeit, which I don't really think it is, if it's not a counterfeit, then, you know, they have not bothered to change their specs. They've screwed up. They've screwed up and haven't changed their specs. You know, if that's the case, you know, if you know, and maybe it's a counterfeit, I don't know. Let's see if I can see what it says on the front. You know, 1,000 feet, 300. You can see the 1,000 feet, 300, you know, 300 yards or meters or whatever, meters, not yards. But it's too bad. It's a nice looking watch, you know. I was looking forward to it. I wanted to wear it, you know. I never did actually wear it out. I just put it in my wrist, and then I realized it was too small. I'm almost tempted to God, I'm tempted to almost keep the damn thing. He actually, and to be fair to the guy who sold it to me, he offered me $30 off, to refund me $30 the price to keep the watch. But like I told him, then I'd sell the watch that looks too small for my wrist, in my opinion, for me, what I want. You know, it doesn't look bad here, really, but you know, it's a good-looking watch, but I've got enough watches that are this size. I've got several watches that are this size, and I'm getting old and fat, I guess. I'm just not digging that size of a watch anymore. So, well, that's it, folks. This goes back to the sales of the company, the eBay guy, and I would relish your input. I mean, besides the fact that I'm an idiot for buying one of these watches, but I would. Do you guys have a military watch automatic like this? And if you measure it with a caliper, you can get these for $2.99 from Harbor Freight. You know, $2.99. And I'm just curious if you'd measure your watches, if you have one. There's not too many videos on these on YouTube. But I suspect they've changed their size and just didn't tell anybody. Or something. Maybe there's a contract for, you know, they do contracts for different groups, so they say. Maybe this is a contract and they want a smaller watch. I do not know. It's very strange. But anyway, I'm getting my money back. I'm going to take that money and probably put it toward a Steinhardt, which I've been lusting for a long time. I never had an automatic watch before, really. I've got one. I've got a Seiko, but I kind of wanted to have an automatic watch. You got a focus camera? Is this camera focusing? It better be. But, well, that's it, I guess. Very strange. Very strange situation. I've only had this for about 3 or 4 days, and I'm almost tempted to see if I can find one of these somewhere else with the right measurements. I'm almost tempted because I do like the watch. You know, I know these have a terrible reputation on Watch You Seek. They made a lot of videos on them, you know. But I've also seen guys who just love their military watch company watch. I will say this, when I was adjusting, I think it was the date on this thing, the hands would kind of wobble a little bit, which you shouldn't really be doing, but that's just what they do. It's got to do with the movement that was associated with his watch, you know. But I'll tell you, I wish it's been the right size. I'm actually tempted to see if I can find one that is the right size. I'm almost tempted to do that because I kind of like the watch, you know. Well, that's it. I'll talk to you later, guys and gals. Hope you're enjoying your life and enjoying your watches. This video went on way too long. I'm sorry I rambled. I will talk to you later, guys.